The badness is not within the technology. The badness is within people and the lack of good behavior, good policies, and good check and balances.
Inequality, another word to come up with AI is automation. And automation gives a lot of scale to people who know how to handle it, but it can also result in depriving from those who can't. Can you please share your thoughts on that as well?
It has the potential to democratize and bring good to people in a more massive way, but it also helps to concentrate wealth and power for those who have the data, the compute, and the business models. So I think AI is part of the equation. I think it's not the only element. Policy making, regulatory measures, civil society participation are together part of the equation. Left alone, I do worry. We have seen that internet technology. The badness is not within the technology. The badness is within people and the lack of good behavior, good policies, and good check and balances. There's no independent machine values. Machine values are human values. They reflect our human values. Telemedicine is a technology that is drastically scaled up because of COVID. You know, when I have some minor issue for the first time in the past year, I'm enjoying video calls with my doctors, never before. And that is a concrete example of medicine being democratized and creating more equity. But in the meantime, we have to be vigilant about who gets access. The unfairness and the lack of equity that comes in every part of the system. It's people behind all these systems, decision makings, deployments. And if we're not careful, it creeps in everywhere. And we just need to have that multi-stakeholder approach from policy to education to check and balances to make sure this doesn't happen.
I just had. I also wonder that what are you most concerned about? What do you see and what are the things that you as an AI scholar that we as a humanity should look out for?
If you ask me to single out the most important thing, I think it would be a new generations, actually I say plural, a new generations of technologists, policymakers, business leaders, practitioners who have that deep bilingual understanding of technology and humanism. Every American teenager learns driving around 16 years old, and they not only have to learn a little bit of the mechanics of car, how it works to move the car, but they also have to learn the laws of driving as well as the personal responsibility. So I think that is an analogy I want to make, is that whether the next generations aspire to be business person or policymaker or teacher or technologist, our education and our framework that we develop today needs to be much better than what we did before. It needs to be much more balanced with human centeredness together with the technology. I literally had Silicon Valley software engineers in tears talking to me and say, I want to do good with technology. I've never taken a single class, read a single book on this. My entire training from K-12 all the way to where I get my Silicon Valley software engineer job is computer science. And we don't want the next generation to be in that position. And that's what keeps me, when I awake every day thinking about HAI and the importance of our work, I think about these new generations.
Right. The more importance and the role of educators and people like you to educate the leaders of our next generation and input kind of population to be aware of pitfalls and also have them trained to use a powerful tool in the right way.
Well, I do want to say people like you play a hugely important role too. I think we're all students and all educators in our own respective organizations. We continue to learn, but we also do lead and need to disseminate that belief, and business leaders play a critically important role. I truly believe that we need to engage with business leaders like you, along with other stakeholders of the society.
Something that seems to be fair and equity to one group of people might not seem to be that way. And that's why we have to constantly look for thoughts and perspectives.